Where's Bill?
Out somewhere.
Where?
I don't know.
That's a fine man you picked yourself, kid.
Yeah, well, it suits me.
Yeah, but do you suit him? He wouldn't think so, the way he's always playing you down, crabbing how skinny you are.
Well, I am skinny.
No, you're not. You're slim, but not skinny. I know what I'm talking about.
You better not let Bill find that out. He's got a temper, he has. He's liable to break you in half, right smack in half.
Oh, no, he won't. Bill's too busy.
Busy with what?
All I know is there's a blonde actor who's been on his trail lately.
Well, what about it?
You don't care if he goes out with other women?
He can go out with 40 women if he wants to. I've got him. Not that I believe you. Bill's no cheat. If he wanted anyone else, he'd come to me first and tell me about it.
Well, if he ever does, you know where I'm at.
You? I'd never even met Bill, and you're the last person in the world you couldn't get near me. Now, how do you like that?
Swell. Gives me something to work on. Different men work in different ways. Me, I got one principle. Take your time.
I don't want to listen to you anymore. Get out of here, Bragg, and stay out.
Sure. There's no hurry.
So, when you served those papers on me, you let me in for a suit for 10,000 smackers for alienation of affection.
Well, what do you want to go around alienating affections for?
The guy angeled my act. Can't get backing without some kind of an IOU.
What do you want out of me, more backing?
No, you're not the angel type.
What's the party for, then?
Just to get acquainted. You certainly showed up those three little Fauntleroys that were supposed to keep process servers away from me.
Midgets.
Well, I gave them the air. I'm in the market for a new bodyguard now.
You don't need a bodyguard. You look like you can take care of yourself.
I always have. Oh, it looks like rain and there's only 5 shows today. You don't have to be afraid of me. I've got nothing up my sleeve, honest.
Nothing I haven't seen.
How old are you, honey?
Old enough to know better.
You know, I got an idea that maybe I'm not going to be around here when that suit against me comes up. I got a chance to go to London.
London? You might as well stay home. Italy, that's the place. Was you ever in Italy?
No, were you?
No, but I'm going. Boy, there's a place, Italy. All they do over there is ride in boats and play guitars. I met a little Italian tomato once. Boy, was she able. Ever since that, I've had a yen to go to Italy. You know, a guy could do himself a lot of good over there.
I bet you know all about women.
I know one thing about them, all of them.
What?
They're all female.
Is that a compliment or a pan?
It's a fact.
You're a funny sort of a beetle.
No kidding.
Looks like I put it back in the stove to warm up.
I had dinner.
Oh. Kind of hot today, wasn't it?
Why don't you say what's on your mind? Why don't you squawk because I come home late for dinner?
You got a right to come home late, Bill.
Maybe I should have telephoned.
How could you with no phone in the house?
Suppose I ought to make up excuses for being late, huh?
Listen, Bill. You don't have to make any excuses to me for anything. You know you don't. You're your own boss, Bill.
You're darn right I am.
Sure you are. Did you pay the installment on the stove?
Yeah. Here's a receipt.
Now you see how easy it is. Only 9 months more and that stove's gonna be ours.
Oh, I bet you're tired. Come on, honey. Lie down.
Butterfinger and Palooka.
Oh, gee, Red, something must have gotten my eye.
Yeah, freight car. Instead of keeping your mind on the game, you've been looking at them trains like you always do.
Oh, listen, Red,
I warned you before. Something's come over you the last couple weeks. You've been no good to us.
Well, don't I get another chance?
No, give me your club. You're through. Hey, Flats.
Oh, listen, Red.
Flats, Graham. Come on, fellas.
How you doing, Ira?
Oh, coming along. Dang weeds grow as fast as you can pull them.
It's a dying-looking layout if I ever saw one.
And you have to give them time to come up. There's no special hurry.
What kind of a thing should you call that? That tired one there.
That one?
Mm-hmm.
That's a zinnia. They're all zinnia.
What do you take for that little old sleepy one?
Nothing. I don't want to sell any.
Give you a dime for it.
Rather keep them if you don't mind, Bill. I'd just as soon wait until they come up a little stronger. Then you can have all you want.
See you later, Ira.
You know, if this keeps up, Ira, you're going to have the neighbors talking about you.
Let them talk. The more time Flossie spends in my shack, the less time she'll have to get into trouble.
How about that dandelion wine you're always brewing?
The more that dandelion wine Flossie drinks, the less gin she'll drink.
You got weird ideas of reform, ain't you? What are you trying to make a penknife out of a battle axe for? It sounds kind of foolish to me.
God chose the foolish things of the world that he might put to shame those that are wise. And he chose the weak things of the world that he might put to shame those that are strong. That's in that Bible you got me, son. Corinthians 1:26. Wait. I'll show it to you.